So, I've been asked this question so many times as to how do we start doodling? What is doodling in the first place? When people say what is your like people say I'm doodling or how do I create doodles? What is a doodle? A doodle is basically a very mindless art form. It's like when there's something else that's going on in your mind, or maybe you're not thinking of anything at all and you have a pen and a book in front of you and you're just scribbling something on your book. That's basically called doodle. Now we started doing a lot of doodle illustrations which you see on a lot of merchandises today. So when you want to doodle something, an object for example, there are a few things that you need to notice just to draw them. I have collected a few items that I have at home right now, and we are going to draw these items. I'm going to show you how do we divide them into different parts and how do we draw them. Okay, so if you are here to just enjoy the session and see what I'm doing, you're most welcome. If you are also going to be doodling with me, that's you're most welcome as well. If you have a book, you have a pencil, you have a pen, that's the most basic thing that we need. Because this is basically how we're gonna doodle, right? We are not doing a mandala of anything of that sort. It's just basically mindless scribbling on paper. Okay, I am gonna zoom in a little so you can see. Alright, so now it's up to you whether you want to doodle in a circle or you want to doodle on the entire page. If you're doodling it in the entire page, your objects will be slightly bigger. I have drawn a circle and I'm doodling inside the circle, so my objects are going to be smaller. All right. Now, what you can do is whatever book you. I'm using an A5 size paper. I take the center of your page, make a point and draw a circle. So the radius of my circle is 6 centimeters. Let's check that once again. Yes, see, it's 6 centimeters. So the 12 centimeter is my diameter of my circle. You can get your compass, take the measurement. If you are doodling with me, just take it on your scale accordingly, put it in your center, and then you draw your circle. I have already drawn a circle. I'm giving you like a few seconds to do that. While you do that, I'm going to show you the first object that we are going to doodle. Now, I'm going to zoom out a little so you know what I'm drawing. The first thing that we're drawing is a Wacom. Alright? Now, the reason I'm drawing this first is because it's quite huge and I have a lot of items placed on my desk to draw. So, we will draw this first and I can, just keep this away. So, if you can see, I am going to divide this. Okay, so what do we see? We see that it's a rectangle, all right? It's a rectangle shape. We have a curved surface here, and we have these buttons over here, which is, there is an inner rectangle. So it's pretty much simple as to how we are going to divide this. All right, so let's take your pen, okay? And let's first draw. You can choose a random, position inside the circle. Not necessary, it has to be in the center. It's anywhere. When you draw the circle, draw it with a pencil, because I am still not sure whether I give an outline to the circle or will I fill in the objects in such a way that it makes the circle. All right. So what are we going to do first is we'll draw two lines. That's what I see in the Wacom. First, we're drawing a rectangle, right? But it has curved corners, right? So we curve from here, go down, we curve it here, go down, and we curve it here. Now there is an inner rectangle that's required. Like I said, I'm drawing small objects because I'm drawing inside the circle. If you're drawing it in your whole page, you can make a bigger object. Okay, I'm leaving some space here because there are going to be buttons. So I'm just going to draw a normal rectangle. I see it has one circle here with 4 dots. All right, and there are 4 buttons here. I'm just going to draw 3. Okay, and we have Wacom written over here. Alright, so we'll first, there are, I can see there is like an inner marking like this. So we basically finished drawing a Wacom. Right, so over here we just need to write it in small. So you see, I've just doodle illustrated a Wacom right in front of you by just seeing the object. So that's what we're going to do with all the objects that I have around here. Okay, so my next thing that I am taking is my highlighter. Now what do you see in this highlighter? I see there is a circle, there's an inner circle. Inside is all the stuff which we're not going to draw, but it's because it's doodle, it's not a realistic design that we are doing, right? So let's draw a circle. I've drawn an inner circle first, then here is an outer circle. All right, I see that there is something over here like a rectangle, so I'm just going to have a small rectangle here and another one over here which I see. So that's what I see, and then we have the highlighter which is written here in the center. So I am just going to write that with a smaller nib. Just give me a second. There. I've written the highlighter and we are done with one more object. Okay, my next one is this Glacier perfume. So what I see is like it's almost like a conical thing where there's a flat surface here and it has two slanting lines, and then we draw with a curved line over here, right? So I have broken this now into different parts. So first I am going to draw is this gap. All right, so what we have here is this is a gap. All right, I'm gonna go down. There is a slight curve over here, so I'm gonna take it this way. All right, I'll write Glacier over here. Now I don't want to we'll fill in some details after we finish drawing the main outline, and then we will fill in all the fillers and the curves and some details inside each. All right, so there we finished one more object. So you see how simple it is to just see objects and design. Now see, here is another, this is a Bulgari perfume. All right, it's a Bulgari perfume, and I can see that this is the cap. So it's a circle, then there is one part here, there is an outer part, and inside here is the bottle. So now I've again divided this into different parts. So how I'm going to draw this is I'm going to go up over here and draw this object. So first I have is a circle, and there is an inner circle inside. You can see the pink and the gold one. Now I'm just drawing this part here. Okay, this has some design on it, so I'm just gonna give some lines. Now I'm gonna give it an outer curve, take it up till down, and then draw a straight line here. And I see there is one more outline. So this is just this outline here. We have to still draw this bottle inside, right? So from here I will just go down, and there we have the bottle. So now I'm just going to write Bulgari. Okay, we have another object which is done. Now I have this mist
what we see is it's basically a rectangle, right? And we divide this into 1 and 2. That's the basic thing that I'm going to divide it into, because you can see a line over here, right? So say I will draw this somewhere over here where I have the cap first. So I'm just first giving an outline of the bottle. I'm giving it slight curve down. Okay, then we have a slight curve value. You know, we finish the body, we go up and give it that. Yeah, inside we see this. So we will, the spray part on top is 1 and 2. It has something over here which is a rectangle, this basically, and I'm dividing this like this, and now there is all like full crisscross designs, right? So I am just going to fill that in. So I've actually told many people that, you know, when, how do you start doodling? So pick some stuff like this around that you have and break them down into parts and draw. So now this is a sanitizer, like all of you can see. What are we going to do here first is we have the cap and then we have the body. So the first we'll draw the cap. All right. So I'm drawing this slightly bigger. This is the cap. I see there is one line here. And there is something over here basically to open the bottle. Here it's curved, right? We curve it, go down and give it slight curve, and you close it there. Now instead of writing Dettol like this, I'm just gonna write it this way. That's it. We're done with the sanitizer as well. You see, it's how simple, it's very simple to illustrate a lot of these objects. Another one here is this art diary that I have. It's the most simplest one. It's basically just a rectangle and we have to draw these, right? It's a book. So I will just move in here. We have this book and I see dots over here. There are 4 threads. Now I see a design over here that I will design. I will see if I take a design or not depending on what I'm doing around. If there are too many things, then I might just want to leave it blank. Yeah, so we're done with another object. Let's take this. Now this is a Wacom pen. So you can see that there is a nib, then there is a triangle, and then we have to go down to the pen and there is this. All right, so how are we going to do this? So first I'm going to draw this part here with a small nib on top. Yeah, so with this I'm done with this part already. Okay, it slightly goes out and then it goes in, right? And there we've also see it's very simple. It clearly depends on just one thing. How do you look at objects? You just look at them as objects, or you then look at it, break it into parts, and then you can actually draw. So let's draw this Faber-Castell pen now, which is in a similar way. First we draw the cap, then we draw the body, right? So let me draw this here. I draw the cap first. Okay, I've drawn a slightly longer cap, but it's okay, I'll fix that. Yeah, and it has lines over here, and then it goes down to the body. There's 1 and 2, and with this we've doodled this as well. So far we've doodled quite a few things. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 things that we've already doodled. Next is this water bottle. So this up part might be slightly complicated, but it's not really if you really, you know, divide them into parts. So when we draw this, first we draw this, then we look at this, we see how this goes out, and then it joins in here. Draw these two things and then the top cover of it. So what are we going to do is, I'm just going to take this part where there's a lot of space. So this is this part. All right, now I am going to draw the thing which is above it. Quite simple. And I also see some lines here. So here we've drawn the cap, then there is like some space here, and then down we have the bottle, right? Next I have is this ruler. It's very simple to draw the ruler, so I'm just going to avoid that. I'm not going to draw the ruler. Let's draw. Now I see there's a lot of space around, right? We can doodle a lot of other things as well. Let's say we have this Sharpie over here. So again, I'm gonna draw the nib, the cap of the pen, and then the body down. Right, I think we all have combs at home. So we have, I have a teeth comb at home, and this is how it would look like. Yeah, so we've drawn a comb as well. Let's draw a mobile phone, for example. Now I have an iPhone, so I'm drawing an iPhone. Alright. Now you see my circle is ending in here. I have a lot of space inside. I'm going to cover up all these with fillers. Okay. I will draw maybe one object here, another object here, another one here, and then we will add in the fillers and the details inside this if required. Let's draw a plant. I have a plant right here. So let's draw this pot first. Yeah. And I have a lot of small leaves on it. So it's basically, I've drawn a stem and leaves on those stems. Now, doodle illustrations are not supposed to be perfect, right? We're not doing art realism kind of illustrations. So they need to look like doodles. Right, so here I've drawn a plant. I have my laptop, or say an iPad, or you can draw anything of that if you want. I have a pen stand over here. So this is my pen stand. I'm leaving this open over here because I have pens coming out from it. Right, so I'm just going to draw some pens. Details we'll put in later. What else do we have? I have a lamp, so let's draw a lamp. So I have the top part which is going to So this is how my lamp looks, and there is a design inside of it. We'll fill in the designs later on. Okay, so we have quite a few things that we've doodled, objects that we've illustrated, things that we have seen and drawn accordingly. Now how we'll fill in this. So what I am going to do first is I'll show it to you with a pencil. Now you know how if you've attended my previous workshops, I've shown you how to do these swirls, right? Like go like this. So we're gonna do some of these, and then we'll maybe add some circles, some shapes, because this is a doodle, it's not a mandala, so we don't want mandala patterns inside of these. So I'm gonna start with here. If you're an Indian, you will know what a jalebi looks like, right? So I'm gonna draw some jalebis around in spaces where I feel that it's too empty and I need to fill in something over there. They can be too big, they can be too small, up to you how you have placed your objects around. So I'm drawing a lot of these around, if you can see. Just place them in like in a way that they're not too close, they're not too far. You're just at the right place. Okay, next what I'm going to fill in is, you know, I'm just going to draw some leaves around, very random leaves. You can have double ones also like these. Okay, they can be in different directions. So I've drawn quite a few leaves. Now what I'm going to do next is say from this vacuum to the space I have over here, I am just going to swirl in like this. Okay, and I'm just going to give it like an outline. So I am carving it and using the space in such a way that it uses up a lot of my empty spaces that are there. So here now, for example, I go out this way and then I'm gonna give it an outline. Okay, we're gonna do that around. You can also add in color to make your doodle look colorful. Use your space wisely, accordingly. See where, you know, it would actually look good to have them around. Now what I'm doing over here is I am just going to give it like a leaf strand kind of a thing, yeah. Maybe one that goes this way, same way, maybe one over here. So maybe one here. You see how my space is filling up? You want exactly that. They can go in any directions. So you can actually mix and match both. like I have a lot of space here, so I'm actually using that up. Okay, so now I have that, I have filled up quite a few things. Now I'm just gonna draw these circles. And draw a lot of them. Big, small, however you like. So you see my entire circle is quite full now. So these are all different fillers to add in. Yeah? So you see how the shapes itself have taken the form of the circle. Now there are two choices. One is either, you know, we fill in all the blank space with black, or we circle these circles that we have, the circles, the rounds that we have made, we color them black. So I think I am going to, it's up to you. There are two options that we can do, or maybe you can just leave it as it is, as you wish. What I am going to do is I'm going to color these. You can color the whole space inside if you wish. You can just leave it as it is. You can also color the objects that are there inside. There are quite a few options. Maybe gonna add some more where I feel there's space and I've not drawn the circles. I'm just gonna add some more. Maybe a small one here, small one. Like add a lot of these circles. They look really nice. They look cute actually. And they fill up the space also well. So I have added this whole thing with a lot of dots. First, what I'm going to do is now take an eraser. If you've drawn your circle, you need to erase that because I am not going to outline it with a pen. Remove that, and now I'm taking like a micron pen, 0.05 nil, and I'm going to be adding some details to my objects. I've left them, you can leave them blank, you can also color them, you can add in some detailing as well. Now if you've seen my page and if you've known me now for quite some time, you know that how much I love detailing. So now I'm going to add in some details. I'm going to do the lamp first. So I'm going to draw lines. Yeah. and I'm just going to give this here. Now I'm using my Faber-Castell, it's a 0.3, okay. I'm just gonna darken some lines in this with this point. Alright. Next, I'm going to go to my phone where you say there's someone's reading something, so just some curved lines here. I don't want to show too many apps on the phone. The Wacom, I'm going to leave it as it is because that's how it looks. I don't want to really add in too many details in that. But what I am going to do to the comb, I'm not going to leave the comb as is. I'm going to again give it some detailing. Thick line over here. Okay, so the comb is done, the lamp is done, the phone is done. Now I'm going to come to my pen stand. Now a pen stand has a lot of designs in it, so that's what exactly I'm going to do. I'm going to first give it an outline here and draw exactly what's there. I've added the details in here as well. Let's go to the pot. Now my pot has triangles. Let's give it some triangles. Yeah, and maybe a smaller triangle inside it. So if this is the first time you're doodling, you see it's quite easy that way if you know how to break it into different parts and then draw them. You see, now my pot is also done. Now my diary has a mandala over here in the corner, but I'm not going to draw in the corner. I'm going to draw it in the center of the book here. So a super mini mandala is what I'm doing. The cap over here again is going to have some lines. It's all about adding details however you like. I'm gonna give a line here, and I'm finding it too empty, so I'm just gonna add in more details. Some designs in here. My perfume here again, maybe just a few things here have like a super small flower inside the circle. I'm gonna give another outline here. In this bottle again, it's super empty, so I'm just going to divide this add in some more details here. Now I think the only thing left is the Wacom and the pen over here. The pen already has a lot of details. Maybe I'm just going to add in some lines here. That's about it. The Wacom pen is... might just add some lines here. Over here, 1, 2, 3, 4 lines. Now the Wacom is... I think I've given details to everything except for the Wacom. So what I'm going to do is maybe just give some small lines here. They are half lines, they don't touch the outer border. And this is Dettol. So I'm doing the same thing what I did with Wacom. Yeah, so you see it already looks quite detailed now. Now I'm going to the leaves. You know how we draw leaves, right? We have the stem, and then we have the smaller stems inside. So I'm going to do that to each and every leaf. So out of something basic, now it looks good. You have a lot of things in it. It also depends on the kind of fillers you add in, how detailed you want it to look. You can add some colors. I hope I'm not missing out on any other leaf. Okay, yeah. I think I have covered most of the leaves. Alright, so this is what the doodle looks like. You can also do stippling at some places. Now, I'm not doing it everywhere. There's just certain places here and there. They are at random, depending on how much space is there, what is around it. Something where there's a lot of design already, I would avoid doing anywhere over there. Otherwise, it'll look too complex and cluttered. So I'm not going to stipple around there. Almost done. See? how super easy it is. In the end, I think I'm just gonna sign off with my name here. I will write Natangle.
And show you what I have finally made. So now if you have any questions on this, I can answer them. Those who've doodled with me, I would like to see that as well. I mean, you can just send them to me, DM me, put it on story, tag me. I would love to see what you've made. I might add some color. Should I add color or not? I want to know from you guys. Should I add color to a few details, like maybe the Wacom center, a little to the perfume, a little to the lamp? Should I add colors or should I just leave it as it is? Or maybe I can add some color to the leaves. Okay, I'll zoom in so that y'all can see. Yes, I get a lot of yeses. Okay, so I have Apurva asking me, can we take a particular topic to make a doodle? Yes, like I chose for this session, I chose objects that I have around me at home. You can choose your theme accordingly. You can maybe choose plants, leaves, or dessert, food, pizza. You can choose any theme. You can also choose your bedroom as a theme, and you can, you know, draw all the objects that you have inside your bedroom and you can make a doodle. So like I said, when we just initially started, not necessary that you need to draw in a circle. You can draw on your whole page and fill in the details. For that, when you're filling in the whole page, you have to add in a lot of details. If you're going this small, like the way I have drawn, if you see the size, the sizes are quite small. So if you're going in with this size, you will have to draw a lot of other items, or you can draw these a slight, you know, slightly bigger, and you know, doodle accordingly. So it's completely up to you how you want to do that. Okay, so I get a lot of comments saying color is better. I see. Okay, so I have only Aditi J saying that leave it as it is. Okay, are there any particular fillers or can we do what we like? It's doodle. It's, you can do whatever you like. You can draw lines, you can draw dots, stipple, these swirls and curves and all of that. You can add in any filler you like, as long as it looks good with whatever you're making. Don't overdo it also, that it looks, doesn't look nice. Just go with the flow. See where, you know, sometimes, like for example, in one point, you know, you can just give like 3-4 lines here, then 3-4 lines over here, 3-4 lines over here instead of these circles. So completely up to you. Okay, Pallavi, I will have a look at it. Electronic items, yes. So I have drawn two electronic items in my doodle over here, but you can also take electronic items as your theme and draw everything electronic. So that can be a theme as well. What if you make mistakes while drawing objects? I love that question. So if you've seen the whole live that I have done, so there was a mistake that I made when I was drawing the pen. I went two ahead instead of where I should have stopped. For example, I had to draw only this much line. I went two ahead down. I didn't want to go there. I made a mistake. So I covered it up when I continued downwards. So you have to cover up your mistakes and make sure that you do not make it too obvious. cover your mistake in such a way that it looks like a design itself. Okay, coloring, I think I will have to. Doodle is something like freestyle drawing. Yes, doodle is freestyle drawing. So that's why I said, so today's topic was basically objects. So I just took objects that I have, like for example, this bottle. I took this object, I divided it into parts and I drew it. That's what I did. You can also doodle monsters, faces, cartoons, eyes, lips. You can doodle with anything and everything. And yes, you can add anything you want. I will be uploading this video on YouTube, so once I finish this live, I will share it on my story with the link, and you can definitely watch. Even about a favorite person of ours, we can doodle. You can doodle about anything and everything. Doodle, there is no particular theme that only certain objects or topics you need to doodle about. You're free to doodle about anything and everything in this whole world, whatever. You can also doodle about space, planets, characters, anything at all. I will check your art. You can just maybe just DM me and I will be able to check through your profile then and check your artworks as well. So yes, any other questions about doodle? So this was a quick session because it was getting difficult for me to answer to a lot of people on the same topic, so I thought it's best to just maybe show how I see objects and then just draw them. If possible, can you take a session on how to draw eyes or lips, because they have the power to change the whole drawing. Yes, of course. Eyes and lips, sure, we can do that. We can definitely look into it. Digital doodle can also be done. If you have a digital device with you, maybe an iPad or a tablet or a Wacom, any software that you're using, any app that you're using on your phone, you can also doodle on digital. That's how generally most of the artists doodle to get their stuff printed on merchandises. Now, I was talking about a particular commission that I was working the past few days, and it was a doodle project, and I was designing a lamp. Alright, so it's a doodled lamp that I was working on, and it's going to be manufactured soon enough. So the pictures will be up soon, but I will not share more details about it. But yes, you can basic. So I was doing a digital doodle in and not on paper that time. What do you think is better, color doodle or black and white? If you're going to color, how can we color? Any rule, single color, multicolor? Up to you. Don't fill it with too many colors also, that it looks too cluttered and shabby. You can use only maybe one color. You can club it with a multiple of colors, like say maybe four or five of them, and do it in such a way that the theme itself looks beautiful. Do not mix it with like 15-20 colors and then it looks haywire everywhere. You can maybe do that when your artwork is way bigger, because your details are also bigger. This one that I have done is in a small circle. If I add too many colors to this, it's just going to look too shabby. So you can leave it black and white also. You can do a color, like most of you all have asked me to color these. So I am going to color these after this session, and then I'll put up the final picture. Yes, you can definitely message me, no problem at all. Do you use Procreate? No, I use Adobe Illustrator, but I will be using Procreate maybe sometime next month. And it'll be up on my stories once I do that. Can you please make a live or workshop about drawing big mandalas or mandalas wall mural if possible? Yes, definitely, I can cover that. I have done quite a few and I can cover that as well. No problem at all. I will consider and see how to plan the workshops, because I have quite a few projects, and I'm also learning digital painting, so that takes a lot of time. But I will definitely consider this as well. which app is good for digital doodle. So I've not used any apps as such. Like Procreate is an app I know, which I will be using soon. So I'll be able to give you more views about that maybe once I use it. But you can definitely use Procreate for your doodles as well. I also doodle on Adobe Illustrator. People also doodle on Adobe Photoshop. People also do it on Adobe Draw. So I think you can, if you know how to, you know, go about the whole software or the app, you can draw anything and everything on it. Did you ever try Autodesk Sketchbook? No, I haven't. Are you going to color this doodle? Well, most of you have said a yes, so I will color this doodle. Okay, so I think it was a good session and I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I hope I could share all the information I had with me on this particular subject and could answer most of your questions on this topic. If you've made these drawings, please do share them with me. You already know my handle. You can tag me and I would love to see them. I will come back live soon with something else. Till then, have a good weekend. See you.